I'm counting, so we are recording.
Yeah.
It is weird how it works. You know, it's a manifestation of something.
Exactly. And it's proof that there's no real death. If on the very most basic level, we're living onto our children, our DNA is living onto our children, which is why we probably want to lift our children up as much as we can in a lifetime.
You know, we're helping ourselves.
Yeah, we're helping ourselves too, because we're in that memory.
Right. And we may get to come back at some point. Maybe, probably not, but you never know.
I think we do. I think there's more to it than just DNA, like the animals.
Right.
You know, but I think there's probably more to it for them too than we tend to give them credit for.
Okay.
Like a dog's life, where the dog keeps dying, but then it keeps coming back to the same person. You know, but that's a little far out, and it was sad for me because I didn't like dogs dying.
Right.
For us, you know, we don't know, do we go out there and it's just energy, which gets reassembled, you know, because energy can't be created or destroyed, or do we go out as a unit to fill another, you know, unit, like a person, and then, you know, maybe in this life I'm a woman, you know.
But we see that in our kids. I got a daughter.
Yeah.
So I see myself manifested in her already. And I didn't have to worry about dying and coming back. I'm looking at her.
You're experiencing
it. I'm looking at her. That's what me looks like being a female.
Yeah.
Okay. And that's what my son looks like with her as her mother, you know.
Yeah.
That's what I do. That is how I manifest myself into infinity, the future, you know, the forever. I'm going forward.
I do believe in that, but I also think for us on this planet, in this life, there's a death. So then we don't see our daughter anymore, or son anymore in this life. So what happens then? We don't know.
Right.
I choose to think that we do get some knowledge of what we're doing here this time, and can experience another aspect of life, because just one life is scary, or Sue doesn't show all of these possibilities that we could be.
True. Not for us.
Not for
but
us.
But for time.
Yeah.
It sees us through our DNA. Every reiteration of ourselves, it sees it.
Exactly.
And that's awesome.
But some people are like the last member of their tribe.
That's scary.
Yeah. Because then that line's going to die out, right?
That's what they say.
Yeah.
Even though they say energy cannot be destroyed in man. Matter is matter. It ceases. And maybe it's just the spirit that will cease. Maybe the spirit can hitchhike on to something else.
Yeah, we don't know. In India, we would believe that a worm could be your grandmother. You know, she might have, like, her soul or spirit might have been reincarnated. Or the way I see it, because I don't really understand that religion so much, I haven't really studied it, but, you know, when you die, your energy is released into the universe, and then it's reformed into something, and it could be a worm, or it could be a cow, or it could be a tree, or, you know, it take 400 years or so to even realize what a tree is to a tree.
Right. Right.
But we have this lifespan, 100 years or whatever. Animals, a chicken has 3 years or however long they have.
Yeah. That's scary.
I'm not too scared of death, are you?
No, never was. Death is easy.
Yeah.
is living and fulfilling, you know, the crazy stuff you think of. Not being a female, I cannot give birth to a living thing.
Right.
But being a male and being proud and being strong and being knowledgeable, I can give birth to devices. And that's why I became an engineer.
Right.
I can create my own kind of life. I can make machines that make money for people.
Right.
You know, I developed stuff, you know, and I took some sort of I guess it was a pride, just like a woman would, in, you know, their kid. You know, that was my kid. I invented that.
Yeah, exactly.
And you see him as a young, you know, idea, and then as they mature, you know, you get more and more attached, and,
right,
you know, you watch them blossom into their fullness.
Right. That's why you say I'm a good speaker, because I had to convince people to spend the money on my dumbass ideas that I was convinced was going to work.
And they did, though.
Yes. That was even the scarier
part. Just the power of thought.
But then, you remember me talking to the group saying, if I have to believe in somebody, I choose to believe in me.
Right.
That's the power of my belief. And my mother gave me that when I was a little kid in the hospital. She gave me that little book, The Little Engineer Could.
Yeah.
I Think I Can. That did it for me. That got me moving and breathing.
Yeah.
Because I think I can.
I
believe in me.
I think everybody needs to believe in themselves.
Right.
And everybody needs to know that the only person that you can advance is yourself. You can give people ideas and you can, you know, show them the way you've done it.
Right.
But they have to choose their path and the way that they are responding to things. And so that's why I say we're in this journey together. But we're so separate at the same time, because I have to make decisions for me.
Yes.
And you have to do the same for you. And I can't lead your life, and you can't lead mine. You wouldn't want to.
Right.
Because we believe in ourselves.
Right.
Yeah.
And believing in making a good life for yourself.
Yeah, you have.
And that's what I think the Tao really means. And that's what I think I'm going to talk to the group about next time they come up there. What does the Tao really mean?
Right.
And what does it mean to me? What's more important? And I think I have a good enough explanation. I think it's a formula. You know, like that, what's that famous one that Einstein does?
Equals MC squared.
Yes. Tao Te Ching. What you know about the way of the world, the way of life,
right,
and the way of the cosmos, and the way of people. Who you are today. Your virtues, your character, you know, what's important to you, you know, how you respond to stuff. So, the Tao plus the day equals the chin, and that's the way you live your life. You know, and that is what my culture taught me. My mother taught me that. It's what you know is going to get you places.
Right.
If you got some knowledge, you can get some places. Who you are is going to get you even more, especially if you have any kind of decent characteristics to yourself, some values. Like, when I was talking about love to somebody else, then Emily and I were talking, and I said, Emily, you can't find love for your body. You know, you have to love yourself.
Exactly.
Once you love yourself, it starts showing.
Yeah.
You know, and you start extending stuff to other people, and then they see it and they get attracted to you.
Right.
You know, and that's it, because you love you. Yeah. You know, so there's no love.
You have to love yourself.
Yeah.
And in order to love yourself, to me, it means being a person of integrity.
That's a good one.
And that's what I'm always trying to say to people is, but how do you feel about yourself?
Right.
That's the question. It's not whether you made the money or you got the job position or any of the rest, but, you know, how do you feel about that? Like, I think I told you about that 90-year-old man that I met. He was giving blood. And he was just up there, we were all giving our blood. And
right.
He says, well, and you know what I'd change if I could in my life? And I said, no way, because not a darn thing.
All right.
And I thought, that's where you want to be.
Right.
You want to be
no
a person of integrity.
Yep.
Proud of who you were on this earth, proud of your earth walk. And, you know, you mature into that. You were given a head start because your parents drummed it into you.
Yeah. I love them for it. I always did.
Yeah.
Still do. So.
They talk
even though they ain't here, I still love them. That's crazy. They've been gone a long time.
Yeah.
But every time I think of anyone in my family, I always smile.
Yeah.
And I don't understand why I do that, but I always do that. So I think in my spirit, the spirit knows they're okay. The spirit is happy. The spirit is glad that I got the opportunity to know them.
Yeah.
And I'm still grateful for it, so I smile.
Yeah.
Because I know that's silly for a 70-year-old guy, you know. But
it's perfectly wonderful. That's how we want to be. You know, and that's how I hope, you know, it'll be for me too. And my children or other people think about me, they'll smile.
Right.
And not go.
Glad she's
gone. Well, they might say crazy, that doesn't offend me.
They probably are gonna say that about me.
Yeah,
that crazy bastard finally died.
But they'll do it with a smile.
Yes. Yep.
Finally.
Well, let me turn this off and then I'm gonna check in.
Okay.
See what the sounds